Berikan penerangan.
Okay. Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. I think before we start, maybe Dr. Harida, maybe can introduce the new student.
All right. Okay. Basically, suppose we have three new students, which is two new MSc student and one PhD student. So,
can they introduce themselves? Can you switch on your camera, please, so we can see your lovely face?
Okay, the
more than three, Dr. Harida, because some not yet registered, so you have to help me introduce themselves also for those that not yet registered semester or registered courses.
All right, I think another two is in the pipeline of registering. So yeah. Suppose we have like five. So the new student and incoming student, can you please switch on your camera so that we know which one of you here?
To all fellow, please make sure your student is in the Talimat. It's your responsibility to make sure they are here. So please WhatsApp them and ask them to join as soon as possible.
Can the student introduce themselves, please?
All right. Can one of you to start with? Azrina, is it Azrina there?
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, Azrina.
Okay. Assalamualaikum and good morning. My name is Nur Azrina binti Nur Ahmad. I'm a PhD student under supervision of Professor Datuk Dr. Ibrahim.
So you're talking of research?
Yeah. My research is on the dual targeting of the natural immunomodulators against SARS-CoV-2 virus, in which I will target the two properties of the compound, which have the antiviral and anti-inflammatory.
So mostly you'll be conducting your research and devices or somewhere else?
The research will be conducted in NIH Seti Alam in IMR. Yeah.
Thank you, Azrina. So
thank you.
Next.
The next one, Harisha.
Hello, good morning everyone. Harisha Tangarajan. So I'm under the supervisor of Dr. Ng. So my project is all about methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, for protein for identifying the structural interactions with small molecule drugs for the assessment of drug repositioning potential.
Okay. Thank you, Harisha.
All right. Can we move on to the next one, Hazla?
Assalamualaikum. Selamat pagi. Saya Hazlam Syamin. I'm under Dr. Bazli. So, I'll be taking a research on synthetic biology, specifically on engineering the photosynthetic cyanobacteria to enable it to depolymerize PET plastics.
Okay, thank you, Hazlam.
Alright, can we move to Iwani? Oh, your speaker cannot connect. All right. Okay. Never mind. Later. So, Irfan, is Irfan there?
Yes.
All right. Can you introduce yourself?
My name is Muhammad Irfan, and my research about identification of K-Hub genes in response to combat drug salinity stress in rice through gene co-expression network analysis and elucidated expansion via CRISPR.
Who is your supervisor?
My supervisor is Prof. Zamri bin Zainal.
So, where you will be conducting your research as for now?
Starting already.
At Imbasis?
But for now, it's about computer work.
Okay, thank you. So, any more students?
Shah Jahan, are you here today?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My research will be seen with Azaina under Prof. Ibrahim.
Cannot see your face.
I cannot turn on my camera. I got problem with my laptop.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Any more?
That's all.
So how many master, how many PhD?
I think two, if I'm not mistaken, two master, is it? And is it for PhD? I'm not sure, Harisha. Harisha, master's or PhD student?
I'm a PhD student.
All right. So meaning, two master's and four PhD. So we have total six.
Okay. So Azrina, PhD. Harisha, PhD. Hazla, master
PhD. Master Hazla?
Yes, I am.
Rasuah, Master. Irfan, PhD.
Master juga.
Master. Three master.
Shah Jahan, PhD. Shah Jahan, PhD ke? Oh, Master. Alright.
Master. So, 4 Master, 2 PhD.
4 Masters, 2 PhD. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Okay. So, thank you for introducing yourself. And also, welcome to Imbasis. So I hope that you will be having a smooth journey, a happy journey at Imbasis for the next 2 years, 3 years, okay? Not more than 4 years, I hope, okay? So even though I know every one of you, even your seniors are very happy at Imbasis, and then they want to stay longer, but we not allow them to stay more than 4 years at Imbasis, okay? Okay, so hear that. All the seniors, yeah? Okay, so I'll start my slide. I'll share with you. On the slide, I just received this light very early this morning, so it's fresh from the oven. Okay, so let's go through this slide. Hope you can see my slide. Okay, Dr. Harida, can you see
yes,
my slide?
Prof. Okay. Yes, Prof, we can see.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so I would like to introduce to you, to bring you virtually to the journey at Imbiosis. I hope that most of you, especially the new 6 students already at Imbiosis, already attend lab at the lab and doing some work, I hope, maybe as a RA or something like that. Okay, so I'm sure that you already familiar with the Imbiosis. So I just like to maybe refresh to all the senior student, okay, like to refresh what is Imbiosis is all about. Okay, so a bit on the history. Okay, Imbiosis was formed in 25 March 2005. Okay, so now it's already 18 years. So we will be having our 20 years anniversary in next 2 years. Okay, so under Imbiosis we have 3 centers. Okay, Center for Genome Analysis and Technology, CGAT, Center for Plant Biotechnology, CPB, and Center for Bioinformatics Research. All these 3 centers are led by head of the center. Okay, later on I will introduce you to them. Okay, so as you know, I hope that most of you know that CGAT and also CBR are located at the main building of Imbiosis. Meanwhile, for the CPB, located at the Rumah Tumbuhan, okay, Complex Rumah Tumbuhan, okay, just down there near the valley, okay, near the research plot of Imbiosis and also FST, you can see that building. But unfortunately, the building now is under renovation, so you can't go inside the building because it's under heavy renovation. So all the equipments, all the facility there has been moved out to other places, and some at Imbiosis, some everywhere. Okay, so even the student are relocated at Imbiosis as for now, maybe for the next 2 years. Okay. Okay, so what is the vision of Imbiosis? Okay, an outstanding institute pursuing innovative research in system biology benefiting mankind. So we would like to be the outstanding, I mean to be the first institute that having research innovation in system biology that can be used by the human being. Okay. And then our mission, unravel biological processes and network leading towards exciting discovery. So what we like to have is to know, to understand, okay, what something mystery, okay, unsolved problem, okay, on the biological process and network. So we can have something novel discovery, we hope, that maybe can publish in Nature, or maybe someday in the near future we can have novel laureate, okay, born from Imbiosis. Okay, so this is educational goals. Okay, to bring together highly qualified independent researcher to investigate highly complex biological processes and networks in the best way possible in interdisciplinary teams, to serve as a supportive venue for researchers in interdisciplinary teams as they learn how to talk cross-disciplinary border, language and tradition. So we would like to have Imbiosis as a place or as a venue for all the researchers from different field, from different type of study, that can talk together. Okay, so meaning that we use the same language, okay, and to understand and also to collaborate in term to solve the biological or the research question for the study that we have. Okay, so at Imbiosis we have empowering of teaching and learning. So that's why you are here, because you have been part of teaching and learning, okay, as a student. And we are, as a lecturer, we will teach you, okay. And also, we also learning together with you, okay. And also, for the high impact research innovation, so we like to have the quality and impactful research. So then we would like to have our expertise to be recognized, not only at UKM level, but outside, maybe at the international level. Okay. Okay, so main focus of Imbisys, okay, molecular exploration on the tropical biodiversity and sustainability for discovery of new genes and biomolecule, application of the transgenic technology for the crop improvement and production of the new biomolecules. So as Institute of System Biology, focusing on the omics, what we did here is for the molecular exploration, a new discovery, okay, on the biomolecule. Okay, so this is some of the research focus that I would like to highlight, okay, by the strategic application of the local biodiversity. So at Imbisys, we have many many researchers, many fellows working on different type of plants, herbal plants, okay, and also fruits and also rice, okay. So many of us working on that, okay. And also some of us working on the disease, plant disease, okay, and also on the animal disease. And also fronting national biofood, national food security. As we know, food security is the main agenda of our country, okay, national agenda. So we like to focus as well on the food security. We would like Imbisys be known menjuarai, okay, lead on the food security, okay. So at Imbisys, we have people study on rice, grouper. Me myself study on the grouper, and also on the papaya, and also on the prawn, okay. Okay, so as you know that we need all the research must be in line with the Sustainable Development Goals, SDG, okay. So at Imbisys, we have aligned our research focus to cater, okay, on this SDG. So on the zero hunger, life below water, life on land, okay, and also on the health, okay, well-being, for the human well-being. So all this been in line with all the research grant, okay, even the student, the PhD or master topic that you're having are in line with this SDG, okay. Okay, I would like to introduce you to our human resource at Imbisys, okay. I think most of you know people at Imbisys because we are a very small institute. We only having 28 staff, including academic and professional and sokongan, okay. So at management level, okay, so I lead this management at Imbisys, okay, as a director. And then we have the deputy director, Associate Prof Dr. Goh Ho Han, that also as the chair for the Siswazah committee. Okay, he will be in charge on your study, okay, on the postgraduate study of Imbisys students. So he will be in charge from the program development, audit, okay, audit, accreditations, and up to your classes, your examination, and also your Viva examination, okay, up to until you submit your thesis. Okay, and then you receive your Senate letter. Okay, he'll be in charge of that. Okay, and then we have also head of CGET and head of CPB, okay, led by the Associate Prof Dr. Ng Chan Leong. Okay, he will be in charge of the center. Okay, and which meaning that he also in charge of the labs. Okay, so and also head of the CBR, Dr. Nur Azlan, for the bioinformatic research. So he will be in charge of the bioinformatic labs. Okay, and head of quality assurance, Dr. Kamarul Azlan, that will be in charge of the quality management, quality assurance of Invisys postgraduate programs. Okay, and also the ISO. So also we have that head of the administration, so Encik Zaili, okay, our head KP, ketua ketua pentadbiran, okay. So Encik Zaili, so with other under him will be the Puan Nur Suzana. Okay, you will have a lot of communication with her later on. Okay, and until starting from now, you already have email from her. Okay, WhatsApp from her. Okay, so she will she in charge of all the documentation, all the procedure regarding the postgraduate study. Okay, so if you have any problem, you can ask Encik Zaili or Puan Suzana or Dr. Goh. Okay, so we have okay other staff under him and under Encik Zaili, Encik Shahrin, that will be in charge of the poster for the promosi. Okay, and also for the ganjaran penerbitan. Okay, so if you don't receive your ganjaran penerbitan, you can ask Encik Shahrin. Okay. Okay, and also Encik Faiz and also Puan Malina. So anything related that you need to have my signature, you can ask Puan Malina. Okay, she's my secretary. So or you, if you want to have you want to see me, you can have appointment with her. Okay, so for the then we have the big chunk of the lab management. Okay, so that we lead by Puan Farida Hanim, okay, as Ketua Bahagian Operasi Makmal. Okay, and then under her we have three different units. Okay, unit makmal pendidikan, unit perkhidmatan kemudahan sokongan, unit perkhidmatan instrumentasi. Okay, so all this our science officer, okay, that will help you a lot during your journey in the lab. Okay, so you must know them. Okay, and also know what their roles, so in order to make sure that you have a smooth journey here. Okay, because these people will help you, will assist you, something like maybe the instrumentation is broken, or maybe the the lab is no aircon. Okay, and then the schedule. Okay, so the schedule for pelupusan, sisa and so on. Okay, all these people are the person that in charge of this. Okay, 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 for academics. Okay, as a fellow academics, we have about 18, okay, Hakiki Research Fellow, okay, the permanent one that from Invisys, okay, including three contract research fellow, okay. So the rest are from is a dual research fellow and also the associate research fellow. They are come from different faculty, from FST, from FSK. Okay, and also one international from Indonesia. Okay, so all these people are related in kind of research at with Invisys. Okay, so some of you maybe your supervisor as a dual appointment. Okay, but still you are doing research at Invisys. Okay, so please know all these people, because these people be some of them will be your evaluator for your proposal, research presentation, and also your progress report every semester. Okay, Dr. Goh will later on talk about that on your presentation for every semester. Okay. So under this, we have the professors, we have the senior research fellow, and also the research fellow. Okay. Yes, services at Invisys. I think most of you already know that what service that we can offer at Invisys. So we have many equipments. Okay, most of the equipment are related to analytical services. Okay, so for example, we have the GCMS, we have the LC-TOF, we have the Nano LC. Okay, we have the HPLC, we have the FTIR. Okay, this is these are the equipment are related to analytical chemistry and also metabolomic study, natural product study. Okay, so you can use the equipment with the some charges. Of course, we need to impose the charges to all of the researcher in order for the system to be maintained. Okay, this is for the sustainable of the lab at Invisys. Okay, because the equipment is very expensive for the maintenance, so that's why we charge you some, so it can help Invisys admin to give the best that we can to make sure the system are maintained well. Okay, so I will not talk detail about this. Okay, but just some brief on this. Okay, on the GCMS, okay, so you can see the charges there. Okay, for Invisys user per injection RM200, UKM user RM250, and non UKM RM300. Okay, the person in charge will be Encik Afiq, Syahmi Afiq. Okay, you can contact him. Most of his time will be at the GCMS room. Okay. So, and then we have the LC-TOF-MS, liquid chromatography time of flight spectrometry. Okay, so as for your information, GCMS and also LC-TOF-MS is high demand, okay, equipment at Invisys. LC-TOF-MS, as far as I know until now, only Invisys can provide this service, because the other places, the system is not working anymore. So our system still working after 10 years, it's still working very well. Yeah, here and there are some maintenance need to be done, maybe broken spare part or something, but the system is still well maintained. Okay, so the charges for this MS, Invisys 200, UKM 230, and non-UKM 250. Okay, so the contact person for this system is Puan Sarah or Puan Rafida. And then we have the HPLC. The HPLC is to me is a very simple system, but still is relevant and useful. Okay, for example, if you have the routine work, you can use this system. If you provide the standard, okay, you want to identify the compounds or you want to do some quantification with the standards, then you can use this system. Okay, so the person in charge for this system is Encik Syami. Okay, so we have FTIR as well. Okay, FTIR also is a preliminary. Okay, before you go to LCMS, it's better for you to go on the FTIR. Okay, so at least you will know some of that group of compound that will be present in your sample. Okay, so FTIR is very cheaper actually as compared to the other system, because this one is not that high end. Okay, so you can contact Puan Rafida and also Encik Syami. Okay, so at Invisys, we also have the Omic Data Analysis, okay, Center of Omic Data Analysis, CODA. OK, Okay, this is one stop solution for omit data. Since I think most of you will be working on different type of omics. Okay, you will generate a lot of omics data, so you'll be overwhelming with this data of omics. Okay, so we do have the data analysis center that can help you. Okay, make your life easier. Okay, but there's some charges. Okay. So we have the proteomic, metabolomic, genomic, transcriptomic, and bioinformatic omic data analysis. Okay, so you can contact email koda@ukm.edu.my. Okay, for the details, because the person in charge for the koda will pass your inquiry. Okay, to the correct person, because we have different people working on the different omics analysis. Okay, so for the CODA, as I mentioned, is one stop solution. Okay, so you make your life much more easier when you are doing research on the system biology. So with all the omics and the integrating of different omics, okay, so CODA will help you a lot on this. Okay, so genomics, transcriptomic. Okay, so this is actually the pipeline, how the omics data analysis will be done on the genomic and transcriptomic. Okay, I will not go detail on this. Okay, on the metabolomic as well. Okay, so this is the pipeline. Okay, from the data acquisition, data analysis, and the interpretation. Okay, so the charges will be depends on what type of data that you need. Okay, so also on the proteomics, the pipeline. Okay, also on the bioinformatic pipeline. Okay, for the sequence based analysis, biological network analysis, structural bioinformatic, and development biological data. Okay, all these are the service that we offer at Imbisys. Okay, so I would like to go to the research at Imbisys. So a brief on our research scope at Imbisys. So as you know, as a system biology institute, we are working on the different omics. Okay, so from the omics you can say is a fundamental knowledge. Okay, so but how this omic can be translated, okay, into the translational research. Okay, there's a pathway. Okay, the in between from the omics to translational research. Okay, we have this, the computational system biology, and also the synthetic biology. Okay, in vitro technology and structural biology. Okay, towards all these are towards in understanding the fundamental of omics data. Okay, for the translational research. Okay, so on the computational omics. Okay, so from the omics data that we have. Okay, so it can be translated, okay, by using the computational. Okay, so by using the bioinformatics, then you can do the integrated of different omics as well. So all this can be done at Imbisys by using our different platform. So as a holistic understanding of the system biology approach. Okay, so some over on the phytopharmaceutical. Okay, so this study actually is on the omics guided exploration in phytomedicine in research. Okay, that to find the new gene, the protein, the metabolite that can be used. Okay, to develop for the therapies or the new drugs. Maybe new drug is very ambitious. Okay, but at least for some remedies. Okay. This is what we are targeting, and that what we are doing now. Okay, some of our research fellow are working on different plants, for example kesum. Many of us working on kesum, and also working on the ketum. Okay, we have kesum, we have ketum. Okay, and then we have ulam raja. Okay, and then we have mangosteen, nepenthes. Okay, so all these are the plant that we are working at Imbisys at the moment. Okay, So this is actually from the published paper, okay? Season biology as a foundation for the genome scale synthetic biology. So this is how we translate the system biology to the synthetic biology, okay? As I said, now now I will focus on the translational research because everywhere in the world are working on the translational research. So at Imbisys also we need to transform our system biology's fundamental work to the synthetic biology, okay, for the translational or for the bio product, okay, or industrial design production, okay. Okay, so I would like to highlight at Imbisys, okay, maybe Dr. Goh will mention later about this, okay, all the syarat for the student to be graduated, okay, so you need to have the publication, okay, so publication is a must, okay, without the publication, you cannot graduate, okay, you cannot go to the Senat, even though you submit your thesis, okay, you cannot go to the Senat. Okay, so this is just to share with you the statistic of our publication, okay, from 2021 to 2022 and some of our achievement at 2023 up to March, okay. So this is then also what the sasaran that university give us, okay. So you can see here for this year our sasaran by the university is 84, okay, for the general third index, and for the Q1 and Q2 64, okay. So we already achieved 26, okay, for the first quarter, okay. So I think we are in a good track, okay. I hope by on the second quarter we will achieve 50% of it, okay. So Q1 and Q2, okay, 22 now, okay. So yeah, still in good track, okay. And then the publication other than Q1 and Q2, okay. And this is all the collaboration with the industry, collaboration with the international, collaboration with the national university, okay. And the rest is the other publication, okay. Journals not index, and then also research book and chapter in book and policy paper. Okay, so I hope that all the students will contribute to the publication, okay, and also the new student will see this is like a trend and something that you should be involved to, okay, on your publication. So so I hope that with the strategy that we have, we already come up with the strategy, Dr. Goh explained later, how to make sure that you can publish within the time and GOT on time, okay, graduate on time. So we hope that all the students, especially the new student, will have this in their mind that all of you will be graduated on time, okay? So so this is like to show you, as for the research, okay, without the research grant, we cannot move. We cannot do research without the research grant. We need money, right? We need, everywhere is need money. So we need money to do the research. We need money to pay the students, okay? Some of you been paid by the grant, right? Some of you receive a scholarship, that's good. But some of you just depending on the grant. So your supervisor will pay some of the amount from the grants to pay you to help your supervisor on their research at the same time for you to get your degree, your master or your PhD, okay? So the community received a grant up to 2022, this is about 5 million, okay, 5.7 million, okay. So but for the 2023, not yet. Now we are submitting everywhere the proposal of the grant, so we are not receive any news yet. Normally the news will be come out somewhere in June, July, September, toward middle of the years, okay. So up to now we have about secure about 5.7 million of research grant in total, okay, from the different type of grant, from the national grant, MOSTI grant, industry grant, international grant, and so on. Okay. So, as a UKM warga, okay, everyone need to understand the UKM Teras. Okay. So, I hope that the new student also will have this Teras in your mind and also in your heart. Okay. So, as we are also the University Watan. Okay. Okay. So, for the Teras, talent, ethics, revitalize, agile and soul. Okay. So, bakat, etika, memperkasa, tangkas dan jiwa. Okay. All of these actually in your program, okay, and also in all the curriculum that we have, okay. So it's embedded there, okay. So as a Watan, you need to write thesis in Bahasa Melayu, some publication in Bahasa Melayu, okay. And then for Aiminda, you need to have advocacy, okay. And then translasi, translational, yeah. And then for the holistic, the creativity, the kepimpinan, okay. And for the digital, okay, pembudayaan and kelestarian, okay. And then prihatin, sihat, perpaduan, and majikan dan masyarakat, okay. So at the end of the day, all this teras is to achieve main agenda of UKM, graduan, kebolehan pasaran graduan, okay, graduan employability and penjanaan pendapatan, okay, income generation, okay. So what's left at Invisys, okay? So we have successfully organized 18 seminars in 2022. So many many more will come this year, 2023. Okay, so all the seminars are related to your study, or some are maybe general, but some are very related or very specific to your own study. Okay, so we'll be having a total number of 9 seminar entry from this year, national and national international speaker. So we did, we already have 2 done. Okay, because this year we will be having less webinar due to this year we will be having our conference on the Asian Regional Conference of System Biology. Okay, so we'll be focusing more on that. And also this year we have 3 different postgraduate programs, I mean the activities. So we already have done 2. Okay, the next one be coming soon, IREX. Maybe our president, Persatuan Siswaza Invisys, will inform you about the next program that will be coming somewhere in May. Okay. So Invisys also have series of workshop. Okay. So we have it many years. Even during the after the a bit settled after the pandemic, we have our workshop series. Okay. So it's a very active actually. All the fellow at Invisys are very active in organizing these workshops, and I hope the student will take advantage of this to join, register for the workshop that are related to your study. Okay, that will help you a lot actually. Okay, so we have the microbial synbio, we have the R programming, RNA sequencing, proteomic workshop, pathway construction network analysis workshop, fundamental LC-MS based metabolomics, particle cost of GC-MS metabolomics, okay, CRISPR workshop, and Quest 3 system registration of pharmaceutical and nutraceutical products, okay, advanced transcriptomics, NGS informatics, plant tissue culture, pathway construction network analysis workshop again, workshop on the recombinant protein purification, network analysis in biological workshop. Okay, and also we have some of the career talk. Okay, last year we have career talk on the from our speaker. Okay. Okay, and then the program that we have this early this year the second International Postgraduate Symposium. Okay, so that one held is in January. Yes, it was in January. Okay, and then if we will have this every year. Okay, inshallah. So please join this. Okay, this is one of the you can use this as one of the syarat to fulfill to present oral. Okay, at the conference. Okay, so and also we have the IBAC. Okay, IBAC officiated by our TNC Research and Innovation Datuk Dr. Wan Kamal Mujani. Okay, we at IBAC we bring all the students from different school form 4, okay, at Imbasis. So they will have the hands-on with the seniors, okay, and doing something that interesting, okay, then to make them excited about science. Okay, we want to bring back for the student to minat science again. Okay, so this is some the bulletin that we have. Okay, so we will have the insider for 2023, okay, coming soon, I hope. Okay, and then we also have the Persatuan, okay, Malaysia Society of System and Synthetic Biology, my bios. Okay, so please register for this Persatuan as well. Okay, okay, so our expert, okay, I will not go detail on this. For the our expert, we portray, okay, the research focus of the fellows at Imbasis. Okay, for like for me, I'm working many years on KESOM, okay, to explore the potential of this very humble plant from backyard of your house. Nobody care about this plant. But actually, from our study, from the metabolomic approach that we have done, we find out there's a lot of interesting compound from KESOM that can be used for the benefiting humankind. As you remember, the one that I mentioned about the mission and vision of Imbasis, okay, whatever that we do, we must have something that benefit the humans. Okay, so that's what we did by study on KESOM. Okay, so and also Prof. Dr. Ibrahim working on the herbal medicine to better the COVID-19, because that time the COVID-19 is something big issues everywhere in the world. Okay, so we are so grateful that now the COVID-19 is fly away from us, hopefully. Okay, even though some of the cases still increasing, but it's better than before. Okay, so but just take care of yourself. Okay, so many plants have been used to study on the COVID to boost the immune system of humans. Okay, so Dr. Goh working on that pitcher plant. Okay, that can be used for the industry. Okay, Dr. Leong working on ketum, okay, the very controversial plant, okay, in Malaysia, controversy, but in everywhere outside Malaysia, not controversy. Thailand use it as they have the vending machine for the ketum juice at Thailand. Okay, if you go to Thailand, you can have that drinks in the vending machine. So don't be afraid or don't be shocked about that. Okay. So, but in Malaysia, is still a controversy. It's been very a lot of rules and regulation need to be we need to follow in order for us at Imbasis to do ketum research. I need to write a lot of letter to the KKM, to the police, okay, in order for us to do research on ketum. Okay, but we managed to do some we managed to found some exciting discovery from the world. Okay, And then Dr. Maizul working on that oil palm industry, on that trade of on the insect pest, okay? And then mangosteen, Dr. Azad working on mangosteen for many years now, okay? So actually mangosteen is not new to Imbisys. The work has been done by Prof. Normah before for many years, okay? And then now being carried out by Dr. Azad, but maybe a different perspective, okay? And then Dr. Kamarul Azlan working on the bioherbicide, okay? So from the wheat, okay, something that you something that you just step on, okay, you don't care about this plant, the wheat, but it can be used, okay. So and Dr. Low working on the aquatic animal health, okay, on the prawn and also the grouper. I'm also working on this, okay, to study on the disease of grouper, okay. And so Dr. Hamidun working on the colorant, okay, the food from the ulam raja, okay, and also the from the sauropus, okay. And Dr. Ahmad Bazli working on the synthetic biology of the natural product biomanufacturing. So for the different perspective, okay, for the biorefinery and so on, okay. And Dr. Noor Azlan on the bioinformatic biological database development, okay. So many on the database, okay. And Dr. Sarahani also working on that bioinformatic, focusing on the metabolic pathway construction, okay. And Dr. Imelda working on the tissue culture from different type of plants. Mainly she focused on the mangosteen, okay. Then Dr. Muni working on the plant as well, okay, for the diabetes study. Dr. Halida working on the mushroom, okay, superfood, okay. After this we can just eat mushroom, don't eat rice anymore, okay. Hope that because it's a superfood and also can make us more younger, I hope, okay. So and also Dr. Nisha working on the oil palm, okay, and jatropha. Dr. Ahmad working on that different type of plant using the metabolomics approach, okay. So he also focusing on the diabetes case study. Dr. Hamizah working on the neuroprotective, okay, Alzheimer's disease, dementia disease, okay. So I'm also working on this, okay, by using Kesum, okay. Okay, I think that's all from me. Thank you. If you have any question, you can ask me directly now. Thank you. Any question?
No question.
Question?
No question, I ask question. Okay, so then I pass back to Dr. Halida. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Ain, for a very comprehensive introduction of Imbisys. Hope all the new students and also existing students can get latest information regarding Imbisys. All right, so I think we move on to the next session. The next session is for the introduction of the Persatuan Siswa Zat Imbisys or PSAI. So I welcome our president of PSAI, Akil, to give a brief introduction about this society.
So can you hear me?
Quite slow. I'm not sure others, tapi I dengar quite slow lah. You.
No.
All right. Better.
I think the microphone. All right. I will share my slide.
Okay.
Can you see my slide?
Yes, can proceed.
Yes.
Yes. All right. So yes. I will introduce about Persatuan Siswa Zain Baisis or SAI. First, Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. I bid to the director, Prof. Dr. Sharon Dr. Kain Barum, Deputy Director Dr. Goh, respected fellows and my friends. Okay. And I want to welcome the 6 new students. So we will have some video for you. Actually, this is the one that made last year. Can you see the video?
Yes.
Welcome to Inbices.
So welcome to Inbices. Almost regard Sai. Okay. Let us proceed. So our aim is actually we want to become the representative of the student and become the intermediate for the administration, between the student and administration, like become a bridge between the student and administration, and at the same time we want to engage the community for the knowledge transfer between the institute and the community. So currently, actually, we have 62 postgraduate students, including the new student. We will have 68. 53% of it is PhD student, and 47% is the master student. So actually, everyone needs to pay the registration fee. Every student needs to pay RM10 per entry. I mean, once you registered, then you need to pay RM10. That's all. So these 6 new person, I hope you will pay RM10 to our treasurer, Mr. Pravin, after this. All right. So this is our advisory committee, which is our director, Prof. Dr. Sharon Atakan Baharum, our deputy director, Prof. Madia Dr. Gohohan, and our advisor and our MC today, Dr. Nohalida Kamal. All right, so a little bit introduction towards the SAI committee. So me as the president, so if there are anything, any problem, you can find me at Metabolomics Lab. If you cannot find me, you can find my vice president, which is Ahmad Faris Seman at Proteomics Lab. So the secretary is Nur Afika, and the vice secretary is Yashir Desai. For our treasurer, Pravin, this is a person you need to pay RM10 to at the Proteomics Labs, and the vice treasurer is Nur Amni. All right, for this academic bureau, we have Anis Nadira. And for the sports and recreation bureau, we have Hanini Chela. and the one that preparing all the media and all the video, that very cool video and awesome video, that's one is thanks to Muhammad Fikri Omar. And then for H Lab, actually there is a student in charge or the lab leader. For bioinformatics, you can refer to Vino. For genomic, you can refer to Metlisa. As for metabolomic, you can refer to Nur Azli Radin. And for proteomic, you can refer to Zainul Azri. So if there are any problem in your lab, if you cannot find your PIC, maybe you can also find this student in charge. So our activity, this is the one that obligate we need to do every semester, which is our research progress seminar. The one on the left is for semester 2, 2021 and 2022. And the latest one is semester 1, 2022 and 2023. All right. Like what Prof actually already mentioned, actually we already have organized International Postgraduate Symposium in Biology, Biotechnology and Bioengineering, which established in 2021. So the latest one is on the January 2023. So this one is the some of the action during the symposium. And then we also have a celebration in Gate of Yemen restaurant after that. So if you want to join our organized program, don't worry, we will have a food afterwards. So rewards if you join our program. It's enjoyable. Please join. So in spite of that, we also have a badge. Actually, it started in 2017, and we also do it again 2018. But due to COVID-19, we cannot proceed it again. But the latest one, we on the Valentine's Day, 14 February 2023, we also organized this IBADGE again in Embiasis. So a little bit recap. Let's play some video. If you been... Oh, sorry. Wait, can I play? You can move the highest mountains, cross the greatest oceans, walk across the water, the water. Believe you can move the highest mountains, cross the greatest oceans, walk across the water. If you believe. Okay, that's a short recap. If you want to see all this media, you can follow us in SciBiases Game and Instagram and TikTok and Facebook and Twitter. Okay. Okay. So this is some of the photos during the IBADGE. And as you can see that actually we also been published in UKM Media, UKM Facebook. You can see all the pictures there. And then for Ihya Ramadan, actually we also organized Tadarus Al-Quran. Inshallah, we will hatam it on 25th of Ramadan, inshallah. In spite of that, we also organized career talk, academic visit, BBQ and potluck always, ping pong every evening, inshallah. And then every once in a week, we also play badminton and also futsal and maybe bowling. And we also, actually, I forgot to include here, actually, we got number 4 on Larian University Watan 2022, actually. Cumulatively, it's like more than 1,000 kilometers that covered by Imbaisi students and staff and fellows. Yeah, thank you everybody that joining. Okay, for the upcoming event is actually IREX. So I hope that everyone could participate in this program. This one is led by Shaki. So let's see another video.
Imbiosis would like to invite you to join IREX 2023. IREX is an exhibition that shows research and innovation. We are looking for great minds out there. IREX is open for all. Come join us with the theme Innovation for a Sustainable Future. Don't forget to copy the link in the comment to register. See you there.
Okay, see you there. So hopefully everyone will participate in it. So that, I think that's all for me. Thank you. And then this is our media, social media. You can follow and update with us all the activities. Thank you.
Thank you very much to Akhil. I think it is a very good explanation and introduction about the society. So I hope the new 6 student could join the society, and the fees is very minimal. I think it's only RM10 ringgit will be collected for the registration fees. And as you can see, lots of activities have been organized and still organizing by this society. So I hope all the 6 students can join this society. So without further ado, I would like to welcome Associate Professor Dr. Goh Ho Kan, our Deputy Director of Imbisis, to give a taklimat for briefing on the regulation of the graduate studies. Please welcome Dr. Goh.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Noharita. I think before we proceed, we shall have a short break, right? And also before that, we can have a group photo of while everyone is around.
Okay.
Hopefully, Dr. Harita can help to take the screen shot. And also, okay. Everyone, please on your camera.
So everyone, please on your camera. Fikri, Mark, the mic.
All the committee or PSLI, please say hi to the new student.
Show your handsome face.
The new students are compulsory. It's not you want or not, but everyone are compulsory to be a member. Okay. Right, everyone, please on your camera. It's quite yearly. It's like every 6-month event that we have this briefing to welcome new students, and we have the existing student to join us as well to welcome everyone back to the semester.
All right, everyone ready? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Freestyle. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Right.
Thank you, everyone. I think we're still early. 5 minutes. We can take a 5-minute break now. And we'll come back at 10:45. Is that okay? I think everyone's like long time already. So we can take a toilet break.
Yep.
So we'll come back at 10:45, okay? Hi, everyone. So now we only have 58 participants. Some left us. Okay, I think we shall make a start. It's already 10:45 now. Okay, so welcome back, everyone. So this briefing is very important, especially for the new returning students. It's also important for the supervisor and also the existing student. Just now, I forgot to welcome some of the non-students who are new to Inbiosis, like the intern or RA. Would you like to introduce yourself to everyone? Because you are also a member of Inbiosis now, or even though it's not official as students. Can you show a hand? Who are you and who your supervisor and which lab are you in? This briefing will help you to understand about postgraduate study if you intend to further your study at Inbiosis in the future. Okay, it's also a good experience and knowledge to know about it. So anyone, I think Cindy Nguyen, are you an intern or RA? Are you there? Hello? Not responding. Okay, anyhow, please, the new student, just raise your hand. You can raise hand, right? Is it? Yeah, you can raise hand in the WebEx. Please raise hand. I don't know that you are there rather than you hiding or just online but not there. Please hold your hand up. Six of you. Only four. So, no, Tuan Faiz, you are not the new student, right? Okay, we have Shah, Harisha, not yet registered, right? We'll have your presentation this Friday for the Fast Track PhD. Asrina, Iwani, Aiman, Muhammad Aiman Hakim. Muhammad Aiman, have you introduced yourself just now?
I don't think so. No, not yet.
But he lowered his hand. We are missing two more new students. Haslam? Where is Haslam?
Haslam and Iwani, is it?
Okay. Okay, thank you. And lower your hand. And then if you are non-student of Inbiosis yet, can you raise your hand? Or RA? It's compulsory for you to attend the Dr. Ng session on the lab. Okay, no one raised hand, but never mind. So we'll proceed. So I already put the link. Actually, there's a link of all the document related to today's briefing, even the handout from the 2022 and 2023. I put in there. I updated the slide. You can see both versions in the Google Drive. I put in the chat already all the relevant information. I know you as a new student probably a bit lost when you first started at Inbiosis or UKM in general, especially those international students when you first join and come to a foreign country. So don't worry, we are here to advise you and to help you to get used to your postgraduate life at Inbiosis. So today actually is to introduce you to what Inbiosis is all about by the director this morning, and also the society of the postgraduate students just now. And as for my session, it's about the regulation of postgraduate study. From your before you enter, like you apply to become a postgraduate student in Inbiosis, up until you graduate, and even after you graduate, and the questioner about whether you got a job or not, is all under postgraduate committee. So we have to in charge of the whole process of recruiting new student all the way until student graduation and follow up on the student graduation. So today is about what are the regulation that you need to know about your postgraduate study at Inbiosis or at UKM in general. And as I mentioned, I just want to congratulate everyone who entered Inbiosis as a new student. It's not easy to become a postgraduate student. You managed to join us as a PhD or master's student. So first, congratulations. And congratulations to those returning students. You survived another semester. So hopefully you can graduate soon and welcome back to Inbiosis, or new student will be welcome to Inbiosis. Okay. All the information at the UCAM level, you can get it from the Pusat Academic website. The link is in the slide. So Academic Belajar Pasca Swasta. And some of the guidelines are there also that I'm not going to eat in detail. The one that I'm focusing on is the regulation of postgraduate study 2021. And I think there's a process of updating it now. But as of now, we are following this as the guideline for all the regulation of postgraduate study. Okay, these are some of the guidelines you should have already known as a new student. You need to get the official email, because all the courses are conducted in Microsoft Teams and you need to register using your UCAM email, so-called email Siswa. So you need to register and you will get it done as soon as possible to join the class if you are joining online. But this year, this semester, it should be physical. So please attend the lecture in person unless you are outstations. Then you have to, in writing, apply to your course coordinator that you cannot attend in person, but you're going to attend online as a hybrid. But you need to provide a concrete reason for doing so. Otherwise, you need to be in person to attend the classes this semester. Okay, so all this you should read, and the link is in the slide that you can download from the website. Okay, just to be clear, currently we have two postgraduate programs that you registered. If you are not registered under these two programs, please alert us. Okay, it must be either Doctor of Philosophy or Master of Science in System Biology. We only have these two programs. Whereas those are your senior, your the student before semester 2020 or 2021, they will have a different title for the Master Science in System Biology. They have a different sub-specialization, and their Doctor of Philosophy have the bracket, and currently there's no more bracket for the Doctor of Philosophy. So this is the latest two programs that we have and offering to you all now. So these are the statistics. I think Akhil just now showed some of the statistics of the PSAI members, and some of them actually the alumni already. So we have 36 master alumni and 19 PhD alumni, currently active around 30 PhD and active 21 master. So almost half already our alumni and active students. And this already mentioned by the director, so I'm just going to skip. So basically all are in line with the RAS. We stand for Talent, Ethic, Revitalized, Agile, and Soul of the UKM. Okay, so fall under the vision of the Vice Chancellor. Okay, and educational goal also mentioned by Director already, so I'll just skip, and you can all refer to this. You should know that we are focusing on complex biological processes. So that is the focus. You should learn about this biological network or omics techniques or approaches during your study. So that is the main focus of System Biology Institute at UKM. Okay, and this I think not so focused on just now on the educational program objective. Both programs are set up with this objective in mind, and this is for the master level. So the keyword are the complex biological processes and network, multidisciplinary biological question. You must always bear in mind what biological questions that you are tackling with your project. And eventually, we want you to have a broad knowledge, be calibrable, and understand the latest issue in the topic of system biology. So you have to be resourceful and learn a lot, not just on your project. And be critical in thinking, creative, innovative, and competitive in the job market. Okay, don't be too competitive among yourself, just be competitive with the world. Okay. The program learning outline for the Master 8, okay, I'm not going into detail, you should kind of read about it, it's on the slide. But this is what could be achieved throughout your study. If Master about 2 to 3 years, and PhD is 3 to like 4 years, so you should be achieve this learning outcome from the program, either through your study, through your courses. So we are going to try to help you to achieve this. And this will be evaluated during your viva. After your viva, so you have submitted your TC, you have a panel having a viva session with you. The panel and the supervisor are going to tick the box whether you have achieved all this learning outcome, excellent, good, or dissatisfactory. So if dissatisfactory, then we are in trouble on trying to make you graduate. Okay, so make sure you achieve all these program learning outcome. And also PhD, the term used slightly different. The difference is in the independence and the level. If PhD, you will have a higher level of expectation of you in independence research. So make sure that you actually can demonstrate that by the end of your program. Okay, so you have to be very skilled. If you are a PhD, unlike master, you learning to become a researcher, whereas PhD, you are a caliber researcher by the end of the program. So you call yourself a doctor, then you have to be a caliber researcher, independent researcher that understand different omics and system biology. Okay. So today I'm not going into detail every single regulation, but I want to highlight some of the important ones. And this highlighted important one will have a star on top of the slide that you should bear in mind and refer to. And I don't expect you to memorize this, but you have to know where to refer to, which is these two books, whenever you are in doubt about when you need to apply for extension, when you need to apply for deferment, or what are the regulations involved in your viva. All these can refer to these two books, and it's open, it's not secret. So you all can refer to, and your supervisor can refer to this. So the first point of inquiry should be your supervisor. You should ask your supervisor for anything related to your program when you're in doubt. If your supervisor cannot answer, then only you go to the administrative office, which is Juan Ano Susanna and also Mr. Zaili, and then come to me if still in doubt about the regulations. Okay, so the supervisor need to know all this also and where to refer to. So this briefing not just for the student, but also for the supervisor. It is your responsibility to know the regulation while you are advising your students as well. Okay. So there are many aspects covered by this regulation, all the way from the admission requirement to course of study, what type of courses, and the application registration process, examination, assessment, and also the appeal process if you were given a fail. Okay. So research misconduct also covered, and also the degree conferment and other general things. Also, we will go through some of the key points of this in the next half an hour. So apart from the regulations, you have this compilation of guidelines as well that cover about supervision. However, this compilation is only in Malay language, unfortunately, for international students. You can use Google Translate to help you to understand, but mostly are not relevant to students. This is more of a reference for the supervisor. The supervisor need to know about the supervision, what is expected as a supervisor, how the viva is conducted, and what is need to know about thesis compilation. So you can actually write a compilation thesis if you publish enough number of papers that I'm going to mention later. And also how to proceed if you want to take a fast track student PhD, which is like first class undergraduate. You can actually have a fast track PhD application. That means you need to apply for master, but apply as a PhD student directly. I'm going to also discuss about this later, why is the pro and con. And also for industry, the PhD industry. Okay, all are covered in this compilation of guidelines that I'm not going to details because I'm going to focus on the guideline only for the regulations. Okay, these are like individual guidelines that are being compiled, that one I mentioned, but mostly in the Malay language. And you can get this through the Pusat Siswaza website. Now no longer have the postgraduate center, it's all under the academic center. but however, the website still can be accessible. Okay, from the beginning, the registration, okay, there are dates to follow. And this Takwim or the calendar already come out by the Pusat Academy from the beginning of the year. So you must follow strictly the time when you have to, when is the deadline for you to register as a returning student, and when the deadline for you to register the courses. So it's all stated clearly, including the public holidays of the year. So this will be disseminated to you through Puan Nor Suzana. You will get email, a lot of email from Puan Nor Suzana. So she will send out all the information related to all this logistic. So please take note of the dates. Okay, for example, the deadline for submitting thesis, when the last day before you need to pay for the next semester. I think this will be a great concern to all of you, especially the returning student. Like the deadline for you to capture, so that you know you need to pay for another semester of tuition fee. That's a few thousand you can save if you can catch the deadline. And the deadline for this semester will be 11 September. For you to submit your thesis for Viva before you have to pay for the next semester. So take note of this date for the returning student. For the new student, you don't have to worry about this yet for another 2 to 3 years. But you need to know about, at the end of this semester, you must evaluate all the courses that you attended. Otherwise, you will have difficulty to register for the coming semester. And this is known as the Teaching and Supervision Evaluation System, STPP. And it might be updated later, but the bottom, the take-home message is, you must always observe the time, the deadline, okay? We don't want students to bother the administrations to open the system again if they fail to meet the deadline. Because Puan Nor Suzana always send out reminder, even a few times, to all students to do so, like early registrations and also to fill in the SPPP. Okay? It's not like we don't do our work, we all do our job. It is the student responsibility to take out of this as well. Okay? We are not your parents to keep nagging you on fitting to the deadline. You yourself are responsible as an adult, okay? You are all postgraduate students. And also for those that are new to postgraduate study, it will be a drastic transition from undergraduate to postgraduate. That is a change that you must bear in mind, yeah? You must always be independent now, that be responsible for your own actions, okay? And follow the deadline strictly. It's not our job or your supervisor's job to keep reminding you about that. For example, publication, the effort to write your thesis, everything should be your self-initiative. It shouldn't be supervisor keep asking you to do something. You should think about you do this degree and your supervisor is your facilitator to help you to get to this completion of this degree. Not like you are working for your supervisor, working for your supervisor project. It's rather, it is your program. It is your master, it is your PhD. So what can you do for yourself? And your supervisor is there to facilitate your learning and to facilitate, to buy all the ingredients, the consumable to help you to complete your project. Okay? So you have to take ownership of your own projects, yeah? Especially when you want to, about registration and things like that. Okay, so if you fail to register, you will be terminated. Okay, you will be dismissed due to failure to register. And you need to go through all the appeal process. And it's really troublesome and there will be penalty. So please observe the deadline. Okay, and if you already submitted your thesis, you still need to register. You don't need to pay the tuition fee, but yet you still need to register. Remember that. It's not like you submit this and that's the end. Okay? While you're waiting for the Viva, you still need to register for the semester. Okay? And you need to pay the fee. Either penalty or tuition fee, everything you have to pay within the time. Otherwise, you'll be suspended. Okay? And these guidelines are all in the guideline link just now about payment. I'm not going into detail and how it can be paid. Okay? And the policy in about the payment and things like that, also don't want to go in depth. It's all here in the slide that you can refer to. What I want to highlight is the fee, okay? Probably a lot of you haven't done the calculation on how much it costs for your master or a PhD. Why I need to mention this in this semester is that a lot of students, at the end, they drop out or they're just missing a session because they cannot afford at the end of it. So to prevent that from happening, I need to tell you to prepare on the amount of cost that entail your postgraduate study. Because when your supervisor hire you, they're going to pay you only for allowance. And allowance is not covering your tuition fee, yeah? Unless you save it and you pay it. You have to cover your own tuition fee. It's not covered by the research grant. Whereas if you apply for My Brain Science, that will cover your tuition fee or Zamala for the first two semesters. So all this I need to tell you now, so that you won't get a surprise or at the end you have financial issue, then you cannot pay and then it's all wasted. You spend 2 years and then because you cannot afford to pay the tuition fee, then you have to drop out. We don't want that situation to happen, and it's very sad. And it's also very, very critical for the supervisor because they have to answer to their research grant KPI. If you are just missing at the end of it, it's very irresponsible to the supervisor who hire you using the research grant, because this will make them blacklisted for future research grant application. So this all need to be bear in mind by the supervisor as well. When you hire a student, make sure the student can afford to complete the tuition fee at least, okay? So this is the calculation based on the minimum semester, yeah? And a lot of you won't be finishing within the minimum semester. For example, to GOT for PhD is 7 semester. This is a calculation for only 6 semester, which is the minimum amount of semester you need to enroll as a PhD student. And master minimum 4 semester, but usually 5 or more. Okay, you can ask your senior for the new student. That is not so easy if depending on the project itself and also your own effort. And it's unlike your undergraduate study anymore, which is a fixed period. In postgraduate, it's all depend on how your project turned out to be. You might be very hardworking, but you might be really unlucky. So you have to pray hard that you're very lucky and you're hardworking enough to complete within the shortest time possible to complete your thesis and publication requirement, yeah? Okay, so just a summary. This is for the latest fee for the minimum semester, and I have done the calculation for you all. Just for the tuition fee, it won't be enough. You must also consider your opportunity cost of not earning every month's salary, right? And this somehow will be covered by the research grant, but it won't be throughout the period. Usually research grant maximum only 3 years to cover you. And beyond that, you have to pay yourself to support yourself. So you have to do your own calculation and discuss your father and mother, with your family, not just your supervisor, that they agree to support you in case you don't have enough money. Okay, so this is a total cost. You might be shocking to you that you might need 125,000 for PhD, a local PhD. And a international PhD, you might require up to 200,000 ringgit to complete up to GOT semester. Let's say you don't complete in time, then you will have to fork out more money to support your living in Malaysia. Okay, so this is the reality check from the beginning. I don't want you to be surprised at the end. I want it to be a reality from the beginning that you are prepared for this. Okay, as a new student and also as a returning student, bear this in mind and save up. Okay, don't spend all the allowance that your supervisor pay you. Save up to pay the tuition fee. Okay, so as I mentioned, there will be Zamala and there will be My Brain Science. Please, everyone, apply for it. The deadline is 30 April. If you are eligible, please apply for all this. Okay, and it's very competitive and limited, but you have to be resourceful to get your own funding, right? So don't just rely on a supervisor. And you can go to this website and apply online. Okay, and now that you enter the system, let's forget about the money. Okay, now assume you can complete that, you don't worry about the money, the finance. Now you have to worry about how to complete your program. When you enter, you have to sign all these aku janji non-disclosure thing. So all this paperwork must be done. Okay, that's required. And now you need to know about how long minimum and how long maximum you can do for your PhD. Okay, there's a limit. It's not like you can continue the semester endlessly. For a full-time master, minimum is 4 semesters and maximum is 6 semesters. Beyond that, you have to apply for extension or deferment. Okay, then there is a limit to it that I'm going to mention in the next slide. Whereas PhD, minimum is 6 semesters and maximum 12 semesters, which is 6 years. So beyond that, also you need to apply for extension and deferment. And this is the most important thing that you need to know for this briefing. Okay, and this is the most common thing for the student, okay, that cannot complete their degree in time, that I need to emphasize on this. And if part-time, then you just double the semester kind of, but it's not as like 12 semester for the master, it's like 8 semester maximum, whereas 14 semester for the PhD. Okay, to graduate on time, GOT, master is 5 semester and PhD is 7 semester. That means you complete everything until viva, until standard letter within the 5 semester. Not like you submit thesis at the 5th semester. No, it doesn't work like that. If you want to GOT within the 5 semester, that means your thesis will be submitted at the beginning of the 5th semester or the mid of the 5th semester. Then you have the chance to GOT if you have a good result from your viva that you don't have to revise too much. If let's say you need a major revision, then you will extend until the 6th semester and you won't be GOT. So always, always remember, okay? These are the summary on the deferment and also the extension that you can apply for at the institute level, which is at the postgraduate committee level and also at the university level. You have a maximum of 3 semesters to apply for extension at UK at Imbalsis before the last final chance at the UKM level, at the standard level. Okay, beyond that, it's very hard for me to help you already. We want to prevent the standard level in the first place. So for those in your maximum 3 semesters already, please beware that that would be, could be the final semester already before you fail. Okay, you have spent how many semesters, then you fail it and you won't get a degree. So that it would be the consequence. So it need to be serious about this timing. Okay, don't think that you can keep staying at university forever and ever. It doesn't work like that anymore. Okay, you can defer at maximum of 4 semesters and you can mix them together. So maximum you can defer 4 semesters and extend 3 semesters. That means in total you can add 7 semesters to the maximum of your master and PhD, which is 7 plus 6, 13. So maximum at the institute level is like 13 semesters for master and 19 semesters for PhD. Okay, by adding the 2 up, and you can apply for extension during your deferment, okay, based on the latest guideline. And you must remember, if you defer your semester, there's a consequence that you cannot use a facility. If you defer, that means you are not a student at UKM. Wait, let me see. And if you're an international student that defer your study, your visa will be canceled. Okay, so there are these kind of consequences that you have to bear in mind. It's not like you can apply for this anyhow you want. Okay, there's a consequence to it. Like you're not going to get paid salary if you are paid by GRA. GRA basically is the research grant. So if you defer, you won't get salary. Okay. Yeah, those are the consequences, and then you cannot work in the lab. The priority will be given to registered student, because when you defer, you are not a student anymore at Imbalsis at that time that you defer. Okay, you need to apply before the end of the active semester. Yeah, not like, for example, you are in your 6th semester or master, then before the end of 6th semester, you should apply for extension for 7th semester already. Don't start to apply at the 7th semester only you apply, because that you have to register already. They will delay your registration. Okay, you must apply for the approval to either defer or to extend your semester before the end of that active semester. Okay, don't wait until the start of the semester. That will delay all the process. Okay, this is the current statistic And I mentioned there are two types of degree, right? So they are in different color. The yellow highlighted one are the old degree with the bracket, the Doctor of Philosophy. And the blue color only are the new latest. The other way around. The highlighted are the new program, whereas the blue one are the old program. And you can see a lot of PhD at the seventh semester already. Then they have to start at semester ready. Okay. So after 12, they need to apply until the 12. Only after 12, they need to start apply extension. Whereas for the master, after the sixth semester, they have to start apply for extension already. Okay, these are current statistics. And all the students that registered before semester 2, 2020, 2021, please bear in mind, you have to graduate before 2025. Because our accreditation for this degree end in 2025. If, let's say, you really cannot, then you must inform us. We have to do something about it. Okay? Otherwise, beyond that, or you disappeared and then suddenly want to appeal to resume after 2025, the degree won't be valid anymore because it already passed the deadline of the application. It's all based on the new degree program already. You cannot change the new degree program just like that. Okay, if you register before semester 2, 2020 and 2021. So please bear that in mind. It's something new information that I have to mention here today to everyone, including supervisor. Please bear in mind, if your student registered before semester 2, 2020, 2021, they must graduate before 2025, before the date of accreditation ended. Okay? This is the current statistic of the number of students applied for deferment and also extension. So extension, maximum 3 semester. Deferment can be up to 4 semester. Okay, luckily we don't have reaching the maximum yet unless there's one on the master level. Okay, and this student promised to submit thesis this semester and should be no problem, hopefully. Okay, if you plan to change the mode, for example, conversions we don't have this conversion yet within PTJ because we don't have a top course, so it might not be applicable. But however, the conversion to PhD is applicable here. It needs to be done within the third semester. Okay, it needs to be done in writing. So there's the strategy. Okay, someone uses that strategy, is that they defer the third semester. They defer third semester so that the next semester, when they register is the third semester, that they can apply for the conversion. However, during the deferment, they cannot use the lab. Okay, they have to complete all the writing at home. Okay, you don't know what happened within the 6 months. You might lose interest in a degree already when you are not doing lab work and you are not attending all the things or working on it. Okay, but that 6 months is still your time. Even though you are not registered, you are still spending 6 months of the period to working on your master. Okay, however, you buy your time of 1 semester to get the conversion done. If you really want to convert into PhD to fulfill the requirement of a publication and also a mini thesis, you need to have completed most of your research objective to qualify for conversion to a PhD. So you must bear that in mind and you can consult your supervisor about this. If you are master and you're doing very well within the first 2 semesters that you get publication and also you achieve most of your research objective, then you have the chance of applying for conversion within the third semester. And the deadline for you to submit this application is on the 12th of May by 12 p.m. Yeah. So you have around 1 month plus only to get this done, the mini thesis, auto publication requirement, or evidence of manuscript submission. Okay. So we'll appoint evaluation panel to see whether you qualify to get converted. So far, we have a few cases that converted into a PhD for a master student. Okay, this I mentioned already, no need to know this. Okay, so this about supervision and supervisor supervision, also just for reference. At Embassy, we encourage no more than 5 co-supervisor, okay, unless it is really, really needed. Okay, so we just want to stick to maximum 5, otherwise it'll be burden to the student to answer to so many co-supervisor. Okay, sometimes you have to print every thesis copy to every of this supervisor, and it delay the time, and the, all the course supervisor need to go through the thesis of writing. So it might be in paperwork will be difficult for the student. So my thing from the student point of view, not to appoint too many post supervisor unless they are really helpful and needed in the committee. We don't want a passive committee, but we want a co-supervisor that really help the student and contribute. Okay. However, at Inbasis, every student must have a co-supervisor from Inbasis. Just in case your main supervisor not active anymore, you have a co-supervisor to back up. Okay, that's a requirement. And you must appoint this within your first semester. You must remind your supervisor to appoint your co-supervisor within the first semester. Okay, these are like the criteria as a supervisor. We're going to skip this. Okay. And in terms of student evaluation, okay, so you will be evaluated officially based on your thesis and also your viva. However, there will be requirement to graduate that I'm going to mention. As a master, you have to complete the two courses, BRB 6012 and 6014, in total of 6 credits. And you have to present a research proposal as part of the RBRB 6014 in the first semester. And you have to present your research progress every semester, the subsequent semester, until you submit your notice of thesis submission. Okay, as long as you haven't submitted your thesis submission notice, you have to present your progress. Okay, and there's a criteria for you to submit the notice as well. It's not like you can submit anytime. And you need to present at least once, any either poster or oral at any conference, okay, related to your field and your project. And you need to publish one WOS index article and a thesis not more than 60,000 words. Okay, there's a maximum limit, there's no minimum limit, but cannot be too thin and to make sense. And you have to complete a mock viva session before your viva. So this, you have to tick all the box before you can fulfill the graduation criteria. Okay, you have to pass all the courses there, not just attend. Okay, and the examination will be by one internal examiner and one external examiner. Okay, if you are staff of UKM, you have to have additional external examiner. Okay, it's for PhD. The difference is you have additional 1-2 credit course, RBRB 8022. And now the recent methodologies, the code is known as A014, which is additional assignment. You have to complete a chapter 2 of a thesis as an additional assignment for this RBRB 8014. Your course coordinator will remind you about this. Then the another difference is you must present oral. Okay, not poster, just need to be at least an oral presentation at a conference, okay, or symposium. Like I mentioned just now, the East Bio 3 also can consider as a requirement you can fulfill by attending the international postgraduate symposium organized by the PSAI. Okay, and the thesis not more than 100,000 words and mock viva, but you have to have 2 at least application for a PhD. Okay, and you must always keep this in mind. Even though you pass everything and you don't have the publication, you cannot graduate. And after 1 year, you will get a fail. Okay, you will be dismissed for failing to fulfill all the graduation requirements. If you after viva, you have passed your viva, even though it's excellent cemerlang, but you don't fulfill the publication criteria within 1 year after viva, you will fail. Okay, you will lose your degree. After all the things that you have done, you won't get your degree if you don't get your publication. See how important is the publication requirement. Okay. As if you are international student, you must fulfill the Bahasa Melayu criteria. You must learn or attend some of these courses. I'm not sure it's still up to date, this code, but you must attend and fulfill the Bahasa Melayu for graduation, yeah, for international student. This is an additional requirement. So supervisor, please bear in mind, if your students are international, they have to complete this. So make sure they know about this if they are not here. The publication, this one already mentioned. Okay. And the publication, okay, must be related and relevant, not any publication. Okay, so all this you can read on the 14A criteria. Okay. And The research program I mentioned every semester before thesis submission notice. And it's very clear already. We make the even evaluation form public. For the returning student, you will see this form is on the slide. We make it clear that what we evaluate you based on your introduction, whether it's comprehensive literature review. So you just need to fulfill all these criteria, then you will get a high mark for your progress report. And for this coming semester, the date, the deadline is 26 June. Okay. For the returning student, please take note of this. You have to submit your progress report before 26th of June. Put it in your diary. Yeah, this is the deadline. You must submit this like report 2 weeks in advance your supervisor to check and go through to approve. Not like you send the day before the deadline for your supervisor to go through. You give your supervisor time to go through and read through to give comment. At least 1 week or 2 weeks, yeah? So don't do everything last minute. Okay, I know a lot of people love last minute work, but please be well prepared and don't do last minute work here. And this is the previous semester. We have the online session before during COVID, and then we have a physical session afterward. And this is the latest in February. And well done, everyone who have worked hard and prepared a good presentation and make it a success for this seminar. And thank you to all the evaluator for completing the evaluation and helping the student to improve their research. So you should think about this as a privilege. Not every institute offers such a guidance. It's very troublesome and a lot of time required from the evaluator actually to evaluate your progress report every semester. In other places, they only do it once probably in the whole of your program. And in Bausi, we do it every semester. Don't think of it as a burden. Think of it as an opportunity to get feedback from independent established researcher about your project. You might get new idea or help you to improve on your project and try to maximize the evaluator expertise to help you and ask for feedback, constructive one, okay? And as for the negative one, try to don't take it personally and try to do your best, yeah? And our seminar will be within a week of 10 to 13 July, okay? Just now I said the deadline 26 June, because we need to give time for the evaluator to evaluate your progress report. So take this in mind, okay? This is what you need to know for this semester for the returning student. And the same week will be same apply for the new student. You have to present your proposal within this week or so. So you have to take note as well. It's within 10 to 13 July that you have to submit your research proposal, written report, and also your literature review or mini review. There will be a lot of work for you for the new student. So don't be too stressed. It will be hard at the beginning, but I hope you already will get used to that and keep working hard. Then you can graduate on time. Okay, try to get the chapter 2 done as much as good as possible so that you can complete your thesis as fast as possible. So you do all this for yourself. You are not doing this for me or your supervisor. Okay, to complete your degree, there is no, it's not something trivial, okay, being a postgraduate student. That's why it's valued. If getting a degree in master and PhD is so easy, then there's no value of having it. So, and the degree is depending on how much effort you put in. Not just the degree itself, but what you learn during the degree time. Bear that in mind. Okay. So if you want to get exempted from this presentation progress, you have to submit your notice before the 26th of May. Okay. This is the deadline to submit your thesis notice. And you have to show a completion of lab work by filling in the form if you are working at Embiosis. If you are not working in the Embiosis lab, you can get an exemption from completing this form, okay? Just to inform provide evidence that you are not working at Embiosis lab, and then inform me that you want to get an exemption from filling in this form, okay? If you're not totally not working at Embiosis. And all these forms can be downloaded from Embiosis guideline on the website. So you have this form, if you are RA or intern, you should fill in this form when you report theory. And you want the access card, you have to fill in this form. You want to work out of hours, you have to fill in this form. And as a new student, you have a checklist also to complete. And the checklist, when you completion, before you submit notice, also you have to complete the form. and get signature for all the lab PIC. Okay, so hopefully everyone is clear about this. Okay, this is the form, how it looks like. Okay, and also, and this is the LKC, we call it LKC. Apart from the evaluation form, your own supervisor and your post-supervisor are going to fill in this about your performance. And this is actually very critical. If let's say you disappear for a whole semester, you will get probably a warning. If you get 2 warnings, you will be failed automatically. So you better perform and responsive to your supervisor. You have to work together with your supervisor. You cannot work in independent. Your supervisor basically is in charge of the project, and you must always get feedback from supervisor to guide you on your thesis writing and also research project. If you just keep silence on your own, then you might fail your degree before the end. Okay, they will evaluate you based on your frequency of meeting, level of reading, level of research, your thesis writing stage, and your motivation and overall verdict and comment for improvement. Okay, so for reminder, you are failed and terminated. 2 warnings, you are failed and terminated. Either 2 reminder with 1 warning, you will be terminated as well. Okay, or they will be straight away failed and terminated. Okay, so these are the combination. If you get this as from your main supervisor is the most important person during your degree. You have to work really well with your main supervisor. If you, in any case, have conflict with your main supervisor, you can still get in touch with the postgraduate committee to resolve this. Okay? It's not at the end of the world. You can still be appointed a new supervisor if you want. Okay? But with concrete reason why. Okay, next. So this I already planned out for you, if you are a master. And what semester you complete what stage? For example, you have to finish all the proposal presentation and courses within the first semester after your registration. And then you'll have a 3 progress presentation, like I mentioned. Then if you are very good, you convert within the 7 week of your third semester and you jump to a PhD. So you will have already 1 journal publication. Okay, then within the 5th semester, you want to GOT, you should have already submitted your thesis notice within the 1st month. Then you will submit your, within the 3 months after the thesis notice, your supervisor must appoint the examiner through the committee, the postgraduate committee. Then you submit your thesis within the 4th month. Then you luckily will be complete your viva within the 2nd month. And this is on the condition that you already fulfill the publication criteria, because for in order for you to not submit the notice, you must have the proof that you already submit the manuscript, at least if not accepted. Okay, and if you go beyond 6 semester, you must always submit extension, maximum of 3 semester, or you can defer semester. PhD similarly, just that you must complete more publication and oral presentation and complete the courses in your 2nd semester. So it's color coded, you see. You have the prerequisite of the RBIB 6012 before you can take it in the 2nd semester. Make sure you register and complete it this semester for those returning one for the PhD. For the master, if you want to learn, you can join the class. There is no requirement for you to register, but you can still join the class to learn additional knowledge, because it's all the technical analysis. So if your supervisor want you to go and join, please join. Okay, please consult your supervisor if you need this. For the fast track, it's similar to like a PhD. Okay, last time they must complete an DOT, but now there's no more such regulation since 1st August. So your process will be similar like the usual PhD. The difference is when you join, before that, you have to present already your proposal. The panel to approve your proposal and your caliber, whether you're suitable as a PhD from the beginning before you register. Okay, and we have 1 candidate like that for this Friday. Okay, and the pro is you have the, how to say, glamour of register as a PhD from the beginning. But the pro is less than the con. The con is you have to pay the PhD tuition fee from the beginning. If you are really good and you really have confidence in yourself, the advice is you register a master and you get conversion by the third semester. You still graduate as a PhD. That will really make sure that you really like the program and you don't like sign up with a higher cost of tuition fee from the beginning. Usually that's what we advise for the candidate for the fast track, to register master and get conversion to a PhD in the third semester instead of directly PhD, because you'll pay a lot more tuition fee for the three semester. You save up three semester of master tuition fee if you register a master. Okay, and this is the form for the fast track. So you can refer to this for the candidate this Friday and what you need to fulfill on your proposal. Okay, all this in the slide that you can download from the website. Yeah, refer to this. This will be what you evaluated based on your for your fast track approval. Okay, so the duration, this I'm not going to details. You can refer to this. It's too soon for the new student and for the return student, you have seen it many times. Okay, in terms of thesis, must be written in Bahasa Melayu. This by default. If you don't want to write in Bahasa Melayu, even you are international student, you should apply. Apply, yeah? If international, we always ask them to apply within the first semester. So please write in writing to get approval from us so that you can write in English if you need to. And the only reason that is approved is either you are international student or scholarship requirement or employer needs. You must provide the supporting document. And this need to be done by the fourth semester of master or sixth semester of PhD. Beyond this, we won't approve anymore. You must write in BM, like it or not. This is the deadline. I tell you all now, and I want to emphasize on this. If you don't apply by this semester, even if you are international student, we won't approve anymore. You must write in Bahasa Melayu. Okay, I don't want to repeat myself about this anymore. You must remember this, and supervisor should be responsible for this as well. Please take note of this. If you want your student to write in English, make sure they have applied for the approval before the fourth semester in master or sixth semester in PhD. There is no exception for this because, yeah. And all this is already filled in when you are registered. And this is the form you should fill in if you want to write in English. Okay, it will be signed by your supervisor with reason. And these are the requirements I mentioned. If you want to achieve the excellent, and this is the requirement. So if you want to attend the convocation on the first day, the special chancellor session, then you need to GOT and have an excellent thesis or excellent thesis, either one. If you have an excellent thesis as a PhD, you will have the chance to join the first day of chancellor, which is the most prestige convocation session. Okay, aim for this, everyone, excellent thesis. And this is a requirement for the excellent thesis. Okay, and I think only the doctoral have the chance of attending the chancellor session on the first day. Unfortunately for the master, even though if you are excellent, also you cannot join the chancellor session as a master excellent thesis. Okay, so about plagiarism, all this will be checked during the submission. You have to submit the report, then the main supervisor have to double confirm and sign for you. So this is kind of the process after you have submitted, and you can refer to all this. And this is a checklist before you can submit a notice. As I mentioned, you'll provide the proof. As of now, Embassy is still okay with the proof of submission of manuscript. Okay, in the future, I'm not sure. This regulation might change. Okay, this has been discussed at the university level, whether you have to have the publication before you can submit your thesis. Okay, this is under discussion, but as of now, you can still submit your proof of manuscript submission as a notice submission requirement. Okay, and also the form just now. And the supervisor needs to appoint all this examiner by filling and getting the contact and filling all this form. And this form we have to fill in on the non-plagiarism verification form. Okay, so all these checklists for the thesis submissions. So when you finally get the thesis done after the notice submission 3 months before, yeah, 3 months. You have to submit the notice 3 months before. If not, then you'll pay a penalty of 50 ringgit. So if you really cannot fulfill the 3 months, you can still submit your thesis. you can still working on a thesis, but you get penalty of 15 ringgit. That still be fine, but you have to inform your supervisor to appoint your examiner as soon as possible, even though you haven't submitted your notice. So examiner can be appointed before notice submission. Okay, please take note, supervisor. If your student cannot submit with like additional 3 months, they can still submit before the deadline of thesis submission, but with penalty. However, you have to appoint the examiner for them in advance, even though without the notice submission. Please take note. Okay, so all this form you need to fill in is in the slide. I'm not going to further. Now it's 11:40. Okay, so in terms of comparison thesis I mentioned just now, there's a requirement that if it's master, you have to know less than 2 publications in which one of them are Q1. If it's the doctorate, you need to have at least 4 publications in which 2 must be Q1. And also, it's not a review article. Okay. So I need to answer all the research objective, if not mistaken. And you need to be a first author or corresponding author with your supervisor name in the paper. Okay, there are so many requirements, so you have to follow this compulsory the guideline. The latest one is 2022. So all supervisor, please take note about what is required. Okay, there are different fields for different requirements. And also there's a retrospective kind of doctorate degree and also prospective. And what applicable to embassy is only the prospective. Okay. And yeah. So okay. So these are all the details on the criteria. So I won't go into detail. So please refer to this when if you are intending to write in compilation for the later 2022 guideline and how the format should be. Okay. And in terms of how the process of the Viva, I also don't want to go into detail. You can refer if you are interested. So you all know this anyway. Okay. And this is the only form. Okay. This is how your TC is going to be later on. I already give you all the cheat sheet, even up until Viva, the thesis. This is the criteria of your thesis, how it's going to evaluate the form. So you have, your thesis needs to fulfill all these criteria. You have to ask yourself whether your thesis can take all these box. Okay, so must remember this. And also whether justify you are Cemerlang or you are Lerma, depend on all this. So you want to excellent, you have to fulfill all these criteria. So this is the only evaluation form from your examiner at the end of your Viva. Apart from the learning outcome form just now. Okay, so if you are very Cemerlang, you will get a very minimal correction. There will be like tempo perpetuum, which is correction period less than 1 month. And this is usually the Cemerlang one with just only minor grammatical error. If you are very unlucky that you require additional network, you will get this major. Okay, major. And also some need even thesis resubmission. So treat your thesis. Let me show you the there's no English version. There's English version, I think in someone's site I have hidden, but this is a Malay version, sorry for the international student. Basically there is a revival, the first time, the first Viva, the maximum can be given to you to correct your thesis is 12 months. And after that, you will have a revival. The maximum correction period should be 3 months only. If you cannot fulfill this criteria, you will fail and terminated. Okay, this is how serious it is if you fail during a revival. Okay, and if you are given already the maximum, the corrected must be submitted and will undergo a repeat oral examination. And it must be the deadline include the submission period. It's not like you submit at the end. You have to submit to your examiner before, way before the deadline, so that they can have the time to approve it. Okay. Okay, so these are like for the repeat Viva which I mentioned already. So if you already survived through all this, congratulations at the end. This is the last form that you fill in to submit your thesis. Okay, the final corrected corrected version that's going to be deposited to the library and become a book of your life that you have fulfilled the master or PhD criteria. So this is the final step that you submit your thesis and the evidence of publication that everyone signed, and then you're going to be approved by the Senate that you are graduated ready. Okay, so this is the final form in a way that you can fill in after the final thesis correction. Then, if let's say in any case you get failed and terminated, you still got the chance to appeal, okay? But need to be within 4 weeks of the decisions, or when you get the letter on the decision. Please do so within the time period, otherwise it won't be considered anymore. Okay, and so write to the Dean, Director, and CC to me, and there'll be appeal fee of 100 ringgit for any appeal. And same for the LKC. Okay, if you get a failed terminated, you can still appeal, okay, to write in writing. And yeah. So if you fail to all this, at last, well, we go through this standard level. Okay, we don't want this to happen to university students. It's a bad reputation. And all these are considered research misconduct. You will learn this during the RBRB 601 4 about ethics. Okay, I'm not going into details. Okay, and you can learn more about embassy from the bulletin just now mentioned by the director. And Dr. Noor Halida will be very important and related to all of you because she is the postgraduate coordinator. And also Puano Susanna that I mentioned, and Zed Zaili. And these are our committee fellow on the postgraduate management that we decide on your fate. Okay, so more info, you can join Facebook of Imbalances. As a Imbal student, you have many privileges. You get to attend all the online courses, all the workshops. Like in 2022, we have so many workshop series. In the past 2021, you can join all these for free. Okay, you don't need to pay for the lecture. Okay, you're not guaranteed the food or the hands-on, but at least the lecture you can join for free. That's what we guarantee for the Imbal student. You can join all workshop lecture for free. Okay, you can see all the activity from our website, from the different years, different album, and we are a big family. Okay, and we always celebrate, and Raya is coming soon next month. So for new student, you're very lucky. You come in the right time for celebration. So yeah, so I think this is something that most of you are waiting for on the announcement of the winner for the last research seminar. Okay, so we always give a kind of a small token to encourage people to do better during their progress seminar. And for the February February one, we have 4 winners, 2 for best presenter and 2 for best written report, and each will get 50 ringgit and an e-certificate that Puan Susanna is going to email out to the winner later. Okay, for the master, 10 of you are supposed to present, 1 didn't present, so end up only 9 presented. These are from semester 2 onward students that yet to submit notice. Okay, for the presentation, I only show the top 3. Okay, these are the top 3. So well done for Chi Fong Ting, for No Amni, and well done to No Frikri with the top mark. Okay. If for the written report, okay, so we have the top 3, No Amni, No Fikri, and also No Hanini. Okay, so well done to all the students have this top mark, but only winner only have 1. So I'm going to give the prize to the top winner. However, if you see here, No Hanini is actually doing better in terms of the mark. However, because she submit the report late, there's a penalty. Also, we have a rule. Whoever submit late won't get the award, even though if it's the highest mark. Okay? So bear that in mind so that you submit your report in time. Otherwise, if you are the best, also no use, you won't get the award. Okay? The award you can put in your CV, yeah? So, Tanya, to best written report, No Amni. You are lucky that, No Hanini submitted late. Okay? And well done to No Fikri for the best presenter for master. Okay. As for the PhD, we have 18. Sorry, I think it's get blocked. So for the written report, okay, these are the top mark, okay, and the winner is Ting, okay, and the others also doing very well, all 95. Chuba get full mark, but late penalty, so cannot consider for the award. Okay, so well done to Tuan Ashraf, well done to Muhammad Farhan, and also well done to Anis Nadira for all the well-written report. The winner is Ting. And for the presentations, these are the top mark. Okay, Tuan Ashraf is 99%. Because Shuba submitted late, she's disqualified as a winner for any award for the research progress. So the winner is Tuan Ashraf. Okay, and well done to Ahmad Faris and also Ting and also Nolo Yana for presenting very well during the progress seminar. Okay, so the others, please work harder and do better. So the written report, well done, and the best presenter. You all are deserving winner. Okay, and please get in touch with Anje Sharin to get your money prize. Okay, in terms of publication award, we also very generous. The institute give you money, okay, money pocket, pocket money, if you publish within the GOT period. Okay, so if master within SEM 2 to SEM 5, you have the publication, then you will get, you can apply for this pocket money, okay, for your publication. And if it is PhD, is within the semester 2 to semester 7 for the two publication. Okay, and you have to fill in this form. After you fill in this form, please email to Anje Sharin. Okay, you have to email to inform the committee about it. We don't get the automatic notification after you fill in the form. You will get a form, I think. You will get the form after you fill in. You forward the form to Anje Sharin, yes, for processing. Okay. So one publication, only one reward. If you have the co-author, you have to share. So we only award to one person. You have to share the prize with your friend if he's deserving as a co-first author. Okay. So we only give one award for one publication. So bear that in mind. Can only one person apply for the same publication. No redundant. And the publication might be approved in EREP with the EREP number, reference number, before you can apply filling in this form. And well done to every winner in the past and the latest. Okay, well done, you deserve this pocket money. And if you perform very well, you get this GOT award. Okay, we also offer this GOT award for whoever complete the test, everything within the time. So master gets 250 ringgit, PhD get 500 ringgit. If you are excellent, so that means you not just GOT, but also you fulfill some publication criteria, you get a lot more money. So you get 1,000 ringgit for master and 1,500 for PhD. Okay, you have to fill in the form also, and the deadline is 1 month before the convocation, in case it will be 2023. Okay, sorry, I haven't updated the date. Okay, these are the criteria. You need to have at least two publications in which one are Q1 for a PhD and within 7 semesters, and present oral at international conference. Okay, if PhD. So you need to be international conference. Okay. And no other tindakan tata tertib. Okay. So this form, after complete, please submit an email to Anje Sharin for processing and CC to me. Okay, we have only one winner last year, which is Dr. Muhammad Haswan, our alumni in PhD. He got 1,500 ringgit, okay, for GOT and also FUFI. And this year, convocation was the 51st, and these are the confirmed graduate of this year. So two PhD and one master already approved at the Senate letter. Okay, so the last submission, that means complete until final thesis submission and the required publication criteria would be the 13th October. If you want to graduate within this year, you have to complete all your viva, all the correction, all the publication requirement way, way before 13th October. Yeah, this is the last date we submit for the Senate approval for if you want to graduate within December this year. So put this date in line, deadline in your calendar for the student that aiming to graduate this year. Last to complete everything, not submit thesis, but submit the corrected thesis and all the requirement is before 13 October. Okay, I have many dates for you today. Have this in mind. And okay, you can apply for all sorts of different awards during the period as you study. For example, some prestigious scholarship. All these will open in due time. We are informed the student when it's open. Okay, and Zamala also usually just cover the tuition fee within the first two semesters, but better than nothing. And also we have this Anugrah Hadiah Buku MTBC. So far, no student got it yet, so but I can aim for this. Okay, and also this Anugrah Emas, which is very prestigious. You get a gold medal, and each master and PhD have two winners, one for science and technology, one for social science. And for master, you get 1,000 worth of gold and 2,500 cash. Whereas PhD, you get 5,000 cash. Okay. So, in order for you to get that, you have to have all this record and achievement beyond just publication, but you do a lot of things. So, these are like the criteria. You can read about it if you want to aim for this excellent award. And this is the form to fill in. And I also share this link already in the Google Drive. You can go and simulate the Excel. Like how many publications you have and the mark. If you achieve 80 mark and above, please let us know. We will submit, we'll challenge you, okay? So usually 80 and above will have stand a chance. 80 below won't have a chance. Okay, you can do this simulation together with your supervisor, okay, for your recognition, okay? For PhD and also for Sarjana is different, okay? And you notice that being a committee and everything like that have marks. So you can actually achieve by being a committee member of PSAI to score some of the mark here. So all these are like to help you, to guide you on how to be excellent to achieve all this underground from the beginning. Okay. So like 3-minute thesis, join if you can. Like Ashuba, very active with all the dancing or the extracurricular activity. And then you can go attend conference by getting travel grant or get an award at the conference or research attachment. This is an example at NIG or Chula Long Kong University. And I want to congratulate two students just recently got this research attachment grant support as Prince Songkran University under the supervision of Dr. Nohalida. Well done, Dr. Nohalida. For Nuru Amalia Zahari and also Ivana No Alisha Binti Roslan, they will probably conduct their research attachment in February to May 2024. Well done, the student. Okay, this initiative. Not just by the student, but through the supervisor as well. So supervisor, please take note. Okay, join the society, join the Facebook, and everyone are compulsory to join the postgraduate society. It's not necessary you become a committee member, but you are a member and pay the 10 ringgit fee. And thank you to all the Jiaodan Guasa that work hard throughout the year. Okay, and also giving activities. And I think some of the page become broken, so please work on it, PSAI. And okay, and the If Bio 3 that I mentioned and the carnival, this was this year one, and also upcoming IREX, that you see the promotional videos, you can contribute by helping out and get experience. You are asked the committee how much they have learned and struggled and learned from the lesson of organizing an event. You know, nowadays, a degree won't secure you a job. You have to demonstrate your skill, for example, social media marketing, event managing, event organizing, leadership skill. You can demonstrate that by participating on organizing all these events, being a leader, even though it's hard work, but then it sharpens your skill as a leader. Okay, so another opportunity for students, okay, is the Multipersidang Institute UKM. We want 5-minute teaching from students. If you are interested, please get in touch with me. Every institute will have one. If other institute don't have talent, we can have more than one. But please submit your interest to me about your 5-minute pitching if you want. With like 3-minute thesis thing. Okay, if you are interested, it's 6th to 8th of June. And you will be more info will be shared soon when the director get more information. And end of the year, we have ARCSB. Okay, you can also attend this in Malacca. You can ask your supervisor about this because usually there will be a small amount of money that your supervisor can spend on you to attend conference. Okay, not just from research grant, but from your tuition fee, there's certain allocation for attending workshop and also conference from the university. that you can ask your provider to sponsor you using that amount of money. Okay, all the record should be in the iStar so they can be captured by the system. Remember to record all this. Even if you attend a conference abroad, international conference, please register iStar. And all the IBAC, IREX, all that activity actually register in iStar. Okay, get involved and register and get recorded. I think that's the sky is the limit. Many opportunity for the new student and probably too much information for today, but you can watch the replay. It's all recorded, I hope. And the slide is all available. Make sure that don't get too stressed out with all the things that you need to do from the first semester. Begin with the end in mind. I've told you all the end already, like the form that you need to fill in, what the processes, the timeline. So this is the taklimat for you to know all the things that you need to achieve. So put in all the deadline and plan your timeline as a postgraduate. Then you want to be exceptional, not just GOT, you have to think about this, be well-rounded person, okay? And also, always stay positive and compete yourself, don't compete with your friend, okay? Because it's not a race, helping each other and everyone have their own strength. So your own competition, make yourself every day better and you're not alone, you have friends, okay? You have the committee to help you if you're in any situation, you can always contact Juan or Susanna to as a mediator. Okay, then to support everyone to success together. Yeah. Okay, that's all. And have a great time at Inbiosis to maximize your potential. And when you have graduated, we'll see you at DECTA for the convocations. And you will take a nice photo around the campus. And you'll become alumni. And you have to fill in this form, please. We need this. So you have to fill in your graduate mohe.gov.my. Okay, for those that are graduating soon, you have to fill in this after you graduate, yeah. And any form of work is considered work. So you can say you are working even though you're helping out a family business. Okay. That's all from me. Thank you. And I end my taklimat today. Sorry, it's already 12 o'clock. Okay, I hope if there's any questions from the students, you can either on your microphone or type in the chat. Is there any question? I'm happy to take. Otherwise, you can refer to the slide in the link in the chat.
Dr. Go?
Yes.
For the conversion, is from the master to PhD, is it should be the end of the second semester or the third semester?
Third semester. Before the 7th week of third semester. If you can do it on the second semester, then we will be better. But it's before the 7th week of the third semester. That's the deadline.
All right.
The student must have a proof of submission of manuscript, well-written one, and also mini thesis. And also the mini thesis should indicate achieve at least, if it's 3 objectives, right, at least 2 results they already achieved and the third already ongoing to justify for the conversion.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Go.
Thank you, Dr. Nohalida. I think that's all for our morning session. We'll have an afternoon session after the afternoon break by Dr. Ng Chan Leong. I think that's all. Thank you, everyone. And there's the attendance link. Please, for those students, you can install UKM apps.
I have one announcement. Is it okay?
Yeah, sure.
For the new student, please register the course RBRB 6014 and RBRB 8014 for the registered new student, yeah. Because for the time being, for the MSc on the Iwani and one PhD student, so Hazlam, I think, please.